Yes, Mr. President, I found it a very helpful visit indeed, and I do pay tribute to the military personnel involved at Northwood. I mean, on the day we were there, unfortunately, we missed the Rear Admiral, the commander, because he was attending a repatriation service of yet another Royal Marine who had been killed in Afghanistan. In fact, just the day after, I think we lost another British Royal Marine. And that the sacrifice in Afghanistan is very serious, and we should pay tribute to all troops there, including obviously the British serving there. I felt one observation was, I believe there was quite an issue of overlap on the Somali mission between NATO and the EU NAVFOR naval force, the first naval force the EU has ever done, I believe. We did pick up from NATO, I did ask the question, would a single operational command actually make a difference to the effectiveness on the issue of controlling pirates off Somalia? And the NATO commander, the Commodore there, did actually say, yes, it would help to have a single command. And he did say that there had been problems with the EU not providing satellite information, which had hampered the NATO mission to some extent. They do get on very well. I'm not saying there's a major issue between the two, but I do think, you know, we do think, you think seriously, you're getting the same nations, 21 out of 27, I believe, are in NATO, and there's a huge issue of duplication and overlap, which I think needs to be addressed, because at the end of the day, this is a very important mission in the sense that, you know, this is one of the key choke points in the world, as the report touches on, in terms of shipping being affected by piracy. And the impact on world oil prices, you know, one ship being pirated actually led to an increase in oil prices around the world by 1.4%, as the report touches on. So the implications of this are very, very serious for all of us. So I think this issue of working together and actually duplication needs to be addressed. And I do query whether it might be better to do it through NATO as a more established military force, because, you know, what I observed is a lot of overlap in military. You know, it's the same ships often. You know, they could be one day in NATO and the next day in the EU naval force. And I think that is a serious issue, and it should be debated further. Thank you.